I'm no longer.
Protect the prince! Kill the Hebrew!
Edition of Teaching God's Holy and Divine Word. Please bow with me as we welcome in the Holy Spirit. Dear Heavenly Father, we just want to forever praise your holy and divine name. Dear Lord, we ask that your Holy Spirit fall fresh upon us right now in the name of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, so someone's soul can be saved, rescued, and delivered. Dear Lord, we ask that you remind us that the battle is not ours, it's the Lord's. Dear Lord, we just want to forever praise your holy and divine name. In the precious name of Jesus, we pray and we thank you. Amen. So it is essential for the Christian believer to analyze the vicissitudes of life on a consistent basis. Therefore, please turn with me today to Judges, chapter 15, verse 14 through 16. And we're going to read that from the New International Version. Once again, Judges, chapter 15, verses 14 through 16, NIV, and it reads as thus. As he approached Lehi, the Philistines came toward him shouting. The Spirit of the Lord came powerfully upon him. The ropes of his arms became like charred flax, and the findings dropped from his hands. Finding a fresh jawbone of a donkey, he grabbed it and struck down 1,000 men. Then Samson said, with a donkey's jawbone I have made donkeys of them. With a donkey's jawbone I have killed 1,000 men. Now as we start to critically determine what is going on in this particular scripture and verse, we must understand some background information about what is going on. See, in Judges 15 and 16, the Bible is describing to us the result of a Philistine incursion that meant to capture Samson. The Israelites in Judah hand over Samson when he volunteers to have his hands tied up with new rope. However, when he sees the Philistine forces, Samson is empowered by God's spirit. He snaps his restraint and attacks. Only using the jawbone of a donkey, he slaughters the enemy's troops and shouts out a clever poem about his victory. Then God answers Samson's plea for water. So when we start to kind of go back over these particular verses, we must understand what is really going on. So first thing we need to really analyze is what is Ramath Leah, and that is the heel of the jawbone. And see, the jawbone here is very important because it represents the word of God, the strength of God, the power of God. Amen. So when Samson is going through this difficult time in his life, he is really angry and he is seeking revenge because of the things that have happened to one of his wives. See, in life, we must understand that we have to allow God to fight our battles and not seek revenge for things that other people have done to us to make us angry. Whether you're going through troubles at your job for somebody slandering your name, or whether you're out there in the world trying to make a name for yourself, it doesn't matter what someone says about you, what someone does to you, or if somebody is trying to physically hurt you or do it in a manner where it could really take you down and really bother your spirit. See, the battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. Amen. And see, what we have to do as Christians is understand things through and through, by and by. Because see, when Samson was out there, he was empowered by the Spirit of the Lord. And when you're out there in the field, and when you're out there in society, it's essential for you to understand that whatever you're going through, you have to give it to the Lord. So whether you're going through a battle with drugs, whether you're going through a battle with alcohol, whether you're going through a battle with prostitution, or anything in your life, you have to understand that I have to give it to the Lord. Some people are going through a financial struggle today, and other individuals are just trying to cope well with their families. However, if you give it to the Lord, He'll deliver you. He'll set you free, free indeed. Because see, sometimes it doesn't always have to be such a mega situation in your life that's going on. See, Samson was up against 1,000 men. Sometimes you can be up against 1,000 people on your job. You can be up against 1,000 other individuals that are trying to come after you because of your character. See, sometimes when you walk in that room, and you're shining your light and you're allowing the Lord to shine His light through you, people may become intimidated. But don't allow that intimidation to be a scaring tactic to others. Just allow them to know that that's the Spirit of the Holy Spirit upon you. Amen. See, what happens in this chapter helps us illustrate the danger of seeking revenge. Vengeance leads to a vicious cycle of escalation. And see, what the lesson is in this particular description and verse is, in God's battle, He doesn't always need the best weapons to win. Amen. See, God can make you win in a situation when you have nothing. Samson, all he had was the jawbone of a donkey, and he was still able to defeat 1,000 men within that time. And see, his purpose was to begin breaking Israel free from the Philistines. See, sometimes that is your assignment. And a lot of people want to go out there and fight the world with their intellect, amen, or with their strength, amen. But see, you've got to follow God's plan and not your plan. God is willing to step forward and fight that battle for you so you don't have to tire yourself out. So you don't have to get in the weeds of all of the negative things that are going on in your life. But see, God wants you to give all of your problems, all of your troubles to Him so He can be glorified and so you can be sanctified through the process of sanctification. Because see, God is saying, if you can last, if you can persevere through this Christian journey where things get hard, where things get tough, then it's going to allow you to overcome things and see things through and through by and by. See, God wants you to persevere, but you've got to obey God. You got to obey His commandments. Amen. See, Samson is going through this time and is trying to set the Palestinians free, but he will not accomplish that freedom. But those who come after him will. And we also know that Samson served in this role for almost 20 years trying to make sure that people were set free. See, that's what you have to do today. You have to set yourself free from all the bondage of sin. You have to set yourself free from the devil's tactics that are weighing down upon your body, weighing down upon your soul. See, the devil is out to tempt you. The devil is out to get you. Just like the devil tempted Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane, he'll come at your lowest moment and try and tempt you as well. But see, God is saying, I want to deliver you. I want to set you free, free indeed. Because who the Son sets free is free indeed. Amen? See, God is waiting for you to be obedient to His word. God is willing in order for you to rise up through adversity and become that individual who can overcome any obstacle that they face during their lifetime. But see, are you giving your problems to God, or are you trying to solve these issues by yourself? Are you allowing man to guide you, or are you allowing God to guide you? See, God says, I want you to hasten to my throne. Hasten to the throne of the Lord today and allow Him to save you and give you salvation that you will always utilize in your lifetime. See, when we start to really analyze and break down what we need in our lives, the simple things that we need in our lives is Jesus. See, Jesus will set you free, free indeed. See, what we have to understand is that I want to reach out, and you want to reach out to all the incorrect sources in your life, but Jesus is the source of your salvation. Jesus is the individual in the spirit of the living God that's going to guide you. Jesus is that guidance and that thorough diagram that you're going to need in order for you to be successful on your Christian journey. See, God says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. See, God is the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last, the Bishop of Souls. See, God is. He says, I am. I am the Son of God. You see, you have the Holy Spirit, and you've got God the Father, and then you've got Jesus as the Son of God. And when you start combining the Trinity, you get the power of the Holy Spirit, you get the power of God, and then you combine that in one, and you know that you are saved. So it's like Jeremiah said, it's just like fire shut up in my bones. Then you start saying, glory, glory to the Lamb of God. When praise is on the inside, you can feel the Holy Ghost guiding and moving. There will be no need to boast. I say glory, hallelujah to the Lamb of God. I want to praise. Will you praise the Lord with me? Will you shout the Lord with me? My God and your God, my Savior and your Savior. He's giving grace. He's giving salvation. My God said, I am the Son of God, the great I am. He is here to save you, to set you free, free indeed. Because whom the Son sets free is free indeed. Say amen.